The Labor Party and the Australian Greens have shown they've learnt nothing from the failed experiment of the minority government to which they signed up to in 2010. The Labor Party and the Greens are busily exchanging preferences in this election, especially in those elections where it counts, like in Denison and in the Senate. A vote for Labor has now truly become a vote for the Australian Greens, and similarly, a vote for the Australian Greens will ultimately translate into a vote for the Australian Labor Party. What that shows is that the traditional Labor voter has yet again been sidelined in pursuit of Kevin Rudd and Federal Labor trying to claw their way back into government. What that means is if Kevin Rudd is re-elected as Prime Minister, the Greens will continue to dominate the government agenda, and the real issues of reducing cost of living, of getting rid of the carbon tax, of having job security, of having a dynamic economy where we can bring down the rate of unemployment, all those things will be sidelined in favour of the Green policy agenda, which we know is so destructive to our economy, so destructive to job creation, and so destructive for the social fabric of our society. Therefore, I'm urging you all to talk to your friends, family, colleagues, and warn them that a vote for Labor will translate into a vote for the Greens in the Senate, and in the House of Representatives, a vote for the Greens will translate into a vote for the Labor Party. The only way we can achieve stable majority government with a clear vision for Australia for the next 3 years is to vote for the Liberal and National Party coalition that has shown itself to be stable, credible, and with a genuine vision for the future of our country.